The story of Tubby the Tuba is well known to millions. It's about Tubby's struggle to find a theme that he himself can play and become equal with the other instruments around him, instead of remaining the oompa accent of the band. Doing the honors on tuba is Gary Buttery, who hails from Omaha, Nebraska, and is making his first solo appearance with the Coast Guard Band. Our narrator is the Coast Guard Band's timpanist, John Foltz, from Sunbury, Pennsylvania. John is also the Coast Guard Band's drum major and has led the band on our parades throughout the country, including Armed Forces Week review for President Ford in Washington in May and the arrival ceremonies for Queen Elizabeth in Boston in July. Ladies and gentlemen, our soloists, Gary Buttery and John Foltz and Tubby the Tuba.
Once upon a time, there was a band which was all busy tuning up. First, the oboe gave the B-flat to the clarinets. Then to the rest of the woodwinds. And to the brasses. Up and around the scales they raced, helter-skelter. Faster and faster. All but Tubby, the tuba. A fat little tuba, puffing away, but oh, so slowly. What lovely music, thought Tubby, and sighed. Here, what's the matter, said Peepo the piccolo. Oh, said Tubby, every time we do a new piece, you all get such pretty melodies to play, and I only the lowly bass notes. But they never write pretty tunes for tubas. It just isn't done. Oh, there's the conductor. Shh. First, the clarinets dance the lovely little tune. Then they cry to the flute, catch. Got it, cried the flute. My turn, tooted the trumpet. And the rest joined in. The euphoniums. Bassoons, while Tubby went on, oompa, oompa, oompa. Catch me, cried the little tune, catch me. Tubby picked up the flat little tune and tried to squeeze it back into shape. You clumsy fool, snapped the brasses. I'm sorry, Mr. Trumpet, said Tubby. Well, I should think you would be, said the woodwinds, as they quivered with great indignation. Tubby, said the conductor. Tubby, just what is the matter? Please be so nice to dance with the pretty little tune instead of going oom, ah, oom, ah. Dance! Laughed the woodwinds. Dance! Well, really. The French horn put his hand quietly to his mouth and smiled. And the whole band began to laugh. Peepo the Piccolo. Please, Peepo, said Tubby. I just feel so bad. I don't think I want any company. I understand, said Peepo. Good night. Good night, said Tubby. Sat down on a log, and he looked at himself in the water and sighed. Tubby was depressed and alone. Suddenly, a big bullfrog hopped out of the water and sat down on the log beside him.
Bug up, bug up, lovely evening, bug up, bug up. I said, lovely evening, clunk, 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 clunk. I said, beautiful evening, hello, 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 bug up.
Hello. Tubby just sat. Oh well, said the frog. Oh well, if I'm not wanted. Please, don't go away, cried Tubby. I didn't mean to be rude. Back hopped the frog. Oh, that's all right. I'm used to it. No one pays attention to me either. Really? Said Tubby. Why, of course not. Every night I sit here and sing my heart out. But does anyone listen to me?
No.
Can you sing? Said Tubby. Can I sing? Listen! You try it, said the frog. You mean it? Thank you, said Tubby. Say, said the frog. try that on your band sometime. Maybe I will, said Tubby. Thank you, Mr. Frog. And off went Tubby, as happy as a tuba could be. Said the frog. Most appreciative audience I've ever had. Fine musician, that tuba. Bug up, bug up, lovely evening, bug up, bug up. I said, lovely evening, clunk, 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 clunk. I said, beautiful evening, hello, hello, bug up, clunk, clunk. Good night. The next day, the band was busy tuning up for the rehearsal and buzzing with excitement over the arrival of the great new conductor, Luigi Buglioso. Tubby practiced his oompa and smiled to himself. Pippo caught his eye. Feeling better? Tubby just winked. Here he comes, called the French horns. Here comes the maestro. All right, begin. And Tubby began to play his own little melody. Oh, that wretched tuba, snapped the brasses. He'll disgrace us. The trombone stuck out his tongue. And the trumpets snickered. Tubby, said the conductor. Tubby, I've never heard a tuba play a melody before. Let's hear the rest of it. And Tubby let go with full voice. Why, how perfectly wonderful, said the clarinets. Please, Tubby, may we sing your tune too? Said the trombone. May I? Asked the bells. Here I come, said Peebo. Sitting right down beside him. Well, we have our points too, don't we? Oh, thought Tubby, how happy I am.